Hands up!
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't shoot!
Anti-racism protests that erupted after the killing of George Floyd, an unarmed black man in the United States, is forcing the world to look at history from the victim's perspective and not the winner's. Egerton Ryerson, Ryerson University's namesake, was instrumental in developing residential schools. A statue of him on campus has been defaced multiple times over the summer. Ryerson University announced a task force who will eventually recommend what should be done with the statue. We tried to understand the man behind the statue who lived and died more than 130 years ago at the height of colonialism that ravaged Indigenous populations from Australia, Asia, Africa to the Americas. Ryerson was born in 1803 in Charlottesville Township, now known as Walsh in Ontario, across from the border of the United States. His American family fought on the British side during the American Revolutionary War and moved to Canada after American independence. The British Crown gave them 2,500 acres of Indigenous land in Port Ryers, south of Hamilton. Egerton Ryerson's writings and work as an editor of the Christian Guardian gives insight into his life and beliefs. His actions were blinded by the unquestionable faith in the Christian religion and the British Crown. He staunchly opposed, from 1837 to 1838, armed Canadian rebellions seeking independence from the British. At the age of 18, he joined the Methodist Circuit Riders, a militant Christian group. Ryerson committed to spreading his Methodist beliefs and started working as a missionary on Yonge Street in Toronto. More than a decade later, he would become the head of the Old Adelaide Street Church in Toronto, now known as the Metropolitan United Church. He also worked to spread Christianity among the Chippewas on the Credit River. He wrote extensively about his interactions with Indigenous people and his rivalry with the Anglican Church to attract new followers. With Chippewas, he built a church, school, and houses with a mission to convert them into this religion. Young Ryerson lived among the Indigenous families to spread his religion. But as Ryerson got older and became the superintendent of education, he would formulate a policy to break families up and take away children from them. For him, Christian scriptures were the only source of religion and morality. His education policies would push religious intolerance in Canada. He opposed a bill by a reformist, Malcolm Cameron, for excluding the Bible from schools. In 1847, Ryerson wrote a report on the residential schools, which were then called industrial schools. The language of the report does not leave any doubts about his advocacy of residential schools. He proposed that pupils should reside together from 4 to 8 years. In his own words, he stated that North American Indians cannot be civilized without Christian religious teachings. He recommended a punishing 10 to 16 hour schedule of labor and learning on the young children and deprived them of their family. He wanted his industrial schools to produce farmers and laborers and warned against spending money on advanced education. For now, Ryerson University has put a plaque acknowledging the atrocities against the Indigenous children caused by Egerton Ryerson's policies and affirming the university's commitment to reconciliation. No matter what decision Ryerson University takes, as long as the statue stands, it is likely to be defaced and will remind the world of the horrible consequences of his policies.